Okay, let's get back into it, shall we? He was a stowaway. Well, they wouldn't be in the passenger list then. That's true. But I don't know how we can identify if there was a stowaway. If he's not in the passenger list. If the captain was not involved in the framing, then there's a Chinese guy that did some serious two-facing by lying to the victim and captain at the same time. But I don't know, at some point, it must have been made clear for the victim that he was getting executed and that he was lied to. Yeah, but then again, why was there a mutiny? The captain did something really sketchy since there was a mutiny. At the end, at the beginning of the game, but at the end. Let's continue, shall we? The person in the barrel couldn't be identified, could he? Oh, he was in the barrel! Oh, I didn't get that at all. No, there was someone who died there who was... Oh, that makes sense, he was in the barrel. I just need to see that again. The option was not there, was it? No. It actually wasn't. I just didn't understand that he was in the barrel at all. Or what? Okay, I'm not sure, actually. But I think it meant that we can't do anything because we couldn't actually identify him by any means. Is this Syed? No. And then we had that guy. Alright. Wait, there was someone in the barrel? It doesn't look like it. I think this was the stowaway dude. No, it wasn't. This was the guy who was moved and then... Someone was in the barrel? Where did we get that from? Okay, I'm very confused. That's where the flies were, and the sound in the memory sounds echoey, doesn't it? Oh. Okay, yeah, we can try it again. Yeah, that's right, the flies were in the barrel. Okay, let's hear it. Oh yeah, it's okay. Okay. So he is in this barrel and died in this barrel. No. But yeah, the sound that you hear is muffled, so it's like it's coming from outside of something.
Cool.
And it also says an unidentified stowaway expecting free passage was instead crushed in a falling barrel. Inside a falling barrel. What a way to go. Sure is. And I guess his fate is already determined, and because he was unknown, he wasn't actually part of the passenger list, so we don't have to do anything with him. Alright. Let's see. What else do we have? There was these shoes here, and then something unlocked that I'm not sure what was. Okay. Hi.
Keep pressure here.
Hold him down. Oh no.
What madness is this? 20 years my steward, and never a doubt on your sanity. Explain yourself.
Those ungodly beasts carry a curse. Throw them back or doom us all.
Tie him up and put him in the lazarette with those things. He may yet find his senses.
Come on.
Iradorar!
In worse spots, I think. Where's the rest of his leg?
Okay. So, who was talking? What's going on here? I guess this might have been before. "20 years, my steward." So one of these guys is a steward. And they're trying to fix it up. Where's the rest of his leg? Ew. Who was talking? Was it the captain? 20 years, my steward, and I never doubted your sanity. Was the victim John? It sounded like it. Hmm. We can see here, could we? Unholy Captives. Ooh. I think this is the chapter that I was looking forward to the most, just based on the title. On the cargo deck. Who is this? How did they die? Keep pressure here. All's fine, John. Been in worse spots, I think. Where's the rest of his leg? It could, I think the victim is John. You've been in worse spots, I think. And then it says, "Wear the rest of his leg to someone else," right? Tie him up in the lazarette with those things, he may yet find his senses. Wait, how can the victim be in worse spots than missing a leg? True. Okay. What madness is this? 20 years, my steward, and never a doubt on your sanity. Explain yourself. Those ungodly beasts carry a curse. Throw them back at the doom us all. Tie him up and put him in the lazarette with those things. He may yet find his senses. Who else was dead here? Around here? Oh, were we up? Oh, that moment when you totally miss, like the memory is quite large and it's just a flesh wound. Well, yeah, apparently so. Oh, I forgot to name the victim. And we know he died from having his leg cut off by the steward, right? I think it was a steward. I want to go back to the memory again because I'm so scared. Well, not scared, but so scared. Yeah, let's go with scared. That we missed something and this whole thing just blows up and we have no names. Oh, and been in worse spots, but current spot, missing a leg and apparently dying a few seconds later. Yeah. Maybe it was just something he said to like calm his nerves.
Keep pressure here.
Hold him down. What madness is this?
That's the captain, right?
20 years, my steward, and never a doubt on your sanity.
I need to hear.
Those ungodly beasts carry a curse. Throw them back, or doom us all.
Tie him up and put him in the lazarette with those things. He may yet find his senses.
Come on.
All's fine, John. Been in worse spots, I think. Where's the rest of his leg?
Where's the rest of his leg? All fine, John. This is John. John Davis? Fourth mate. Do we have other Johns? John seemed like a quite common name. Please say we don't have other Johns. Oh, god dang it. Seaman. Okay. So it looks like... John, he was fourth mate. There's only one Swedish person on the list. Yeah, that's true. And then there was the Captain Stewart. I think we found Philip Dahl. So does he look like a seaman or fourth mate? Yeah, that was what I was thinking. Did he have a hat? No, he did not have a hat. He, in fact, just do all mates have hats? I think he's a seaman because he's doing the dirty work and I just wanted to see the glossary. The mate is like really high up. Officer, a tradesman. Tradesman, mate, served as supervisor, general mates. Yeah. Okay. John, you are from Wales, and I forgot what happened to him. He was cut with a sword and he died from it. So he was, I guess he was killed by a sword. Because he didn't die immediately, but he died afterwards. Well, he did die here, didn't he? He was killed by a sword by the Captain Stewart, I think. Philip Dahl. And this guy must be Philip Dahl then. Because he was the steward of the captain. I really hope that was the captain's voice. I don't actually recognize it. Philip Dahl. Era Dora. I'm gonna go with you with what you said, Yuna, that it was Swedish. Clearly missing leg, can't help but notice. Lol, the guy behind the captain looks like the man in black from Westworld. Oh. This was Philip Dahl. Oh yeah, he does. Really. This is the guy who died in the couch on somewhere. And then a lot of stuff happened up here. Oh, this was the artist. That guy. There are so many people here that it looks like we know who they are. Based on the sketch. Hey, they're taking the seashells up. Oh. It's that guy. This was the new memory. Well, it had Swedish on the O sentence. Like, oh yeah, the I don't know what's it called. Accent. It's not an accent. Sometimes the memories are really huge. Yeah. They're really big. Okay, I'm pretty confident in that. But if he was a seaman, we know that these other guys are also seamen and seamen. Oh my god. I can't really get myself out of that one, can I? Well, oh my god, he keeps being in so many memories. And there's a long list of seamen. Why do they have to name them that? Finland, we call it the Swedish O. In Denmark, we... We don't have an... Have we? Do we have a name for it in Denmark? I mean, the letter is just Ø. O. I guess it was O, actually. Oh, you call the letter Swedish O. So, like this one that I'm writing in the chat. So you just call that the Swedish O. Okay. Great, let's get out of here. Where on earth do we get out of here? want to go back. Doesn't look like we can go up. Yeah, that's the one. Not the same. That's. I think Yuna was trying. You're trying to mimic the sound, right? It sort of sounds like an O. Oh, there it is, the door. It's pronounced as, yeah, exactly. Okay, something opened up here. Oh, this one, I guess. Hi. Have we been through all? Bitter cold, loose cargo, the calling. The calling is the only thing we haven't done anything in yet. Great. Yeah, a combination of A and O. Wait, there was someone who... we could grab him. Next one. Was it up here? Was it just this guy here? Yeah, okay, it was this one. Oh no! No! I mean, some of these fates has got to be the horrible thing, the most horrible things. Like, they're getting crushed by some weird random stuff, like falling down. Was this John? Yeah, this was John. Oh no. That guy, we've seen him before. What are they carrying? Is it a big fish? A shark or something like that? Alright. Sure. Hi, a carpenter. Oh, he was a carpenter. And we got people in here. Carpentering. Is that a giant fish? Looked like it. Oh, is this? No, they were still on Unholy Captives. Well, maybe it was the soldiers from. No, that happened afterwards. Yeah. Okay. Never mind. Who is this? How did they die? Well, we know he was in depicting on the way sketch. So memories on the map. Perished in Unholy Captives. No, I didn't. They died by getting crushed, I guess. By... No? Maybe not. Fell overboard, rigging stairs. Now, did he fall down the stairs? Did he fall down the stairs, or... Oh, did he get crushed? I mean, his neck got snapped. Looks like, I think he fell down the stairs. I saw it as a thing ramming his head. Yeah, I think his neck is getting snapped there. I think he fell down the stairs. He fell down the stairs to his death. That also means, it also makes sense that, well, I guess he could have been crushed still. I'm going with it. He fell down the stairs. Wait, someone was dead up there. Huh? Were you already dead? Dun 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 dun. Okay, and who might you be? What killed him, I wonder?
What's your foot in?
Hey there, what's this? Give him to me and I
mac and fries, a solid meal, boys.
Have them now. Take it slow.
Want it, gentlemen? There's a pretty shell here. Let's have a look.
No, get back.
Oh, my. Oh, my. What is it? It's full of spikes, that's what it is. Okay. I can give it a proper fry. He sounds like the cook. Seriously, what's going on here? There's a monster in it. Some fish. Shell, yeah, that's a pretty shell here. So they found this fish, I guess, with the shells on it, and then came the soldiers. Given to me, I can fry a solid meal, boys. One tick, gentlemen. It's pretty shell. Let's have a look. Now get back. So how many cooks are there on board? He got spiked by a terrible beast. How many cooks? The cook? Thomas Sefton. Midshipman, topman. I think that's the cook. He was there. That was two. So let's hope next time we find someone. Oh my god, that was upstairs. That it's actually correct. Oh my, this is also a huge memory. Wait. Dang it. Typically one cook, yeah. Turned out there was one cook. But I have to follow it, don't I? So much death. This is the unluckiest ship in the entire world, I think. But there was something interesting. So I want to go through these memories again, because first of all we want to see what's going on up here. It looks like they're taking the cabinet here with the seashell in it, taking it out. Or is it? Oh, maybe it's going on board. And that's the Unholy Captives. So the soldiers at sea were coming for those, maybe? Probably. What the fudge happened here? Hi. Oh no, this is Chinese guard! The other guard. And then this guy. And here the captain is with his first mate and someone else mate. Is everyone in this shit dead at the end? Yep, that's exactly what's going to happen. No, probably not everyone, because we know some is going to escape. But we don't know, we need to know where they escaped to. But the thing about, I don't know if you watched the first episode. The story is that Obra Dinn, the ship, got into port. 4 years after it was declared. That was Danish. What's it called? People thought it was Danish and missing, and then 4 years after, it suddenly arrived in the harbor of London. With no passengers on it. Or no crew on it. So everyone is probably dead. Or most of them are. Anyway. So this one here. Now, we can determine that this one and this one, these are the carpenters. Speared by a foreign enemy. But okay, we don't actually know which one is the carpenter and the carpenter's mate. Spiked. Because I think I saw the carpenter and carpenter's mate, Winston Smith and Marcus Gibbs. Now, I'm gonna go out on a limb here and say this is the mate. Because he looks African American, and I think in the beginning of 1800s, people were not that fond of African Americans. He could have been carpenter, so I'm not gonna. Well, we just know which one. Okay. There's a monster in it. Typically, the one cook is enough. Is everyone? Seems about right to me here. Okay. I thought that was. Yeah, I don't think we can determine their fate, who they are, quite yet. I guess we could guess. But there's someone else that we know now. Right? Where was the guy who got shot? We got a name, Mr. Wolf. It's up here. I think it was this guy. Murder. Yeah, okay, we know.
Huck Seng Lao, you have been found guilty by so self-defection.
This is
of the murder of Nunzio Pasquale.
Mr. Wolf, do we know who he is? He was decapitated by the beast.
As captain of this ship, and by the other.
Murder part two. He was Mr. Wolf. Where, when you are ready.
Of right. The East India Company, and thus the Crown of England.
This one.
I sentence you to death.
Death. This guy, Mr. Wolf, and he has a beautiful hat on. Christian Wolf, a gunner from Austria. Well, it makes sense that it was a gunner, because he was the one giving the order. Do we have others? I don't think. I guess since he's from Austria, it's Wolf. Wolf. Bum, 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 bum. Christian Wolf.
By firing line.
Now we have three names, but not all of them were correct.
Right, sir. Ready, men.
Dang it!
Fire.
God dang it! Oh, maybe we didn't have. Was it only two? Was it this one? This guy we needed? Okay, we know he's a seaman. Oh, that was the other one with the hat on, with the funny hat. Or the other one from Austria. There were only two from Austria, right? Perished in escape. Yeah, he died in a chair. Who is this? Austria. The boatswain, the bosun. Alfred Clistel. Christian Wolf from Austria. Okay, I'm gonna go down to that memory and get him. Where was that? It was somewhere down here. Oh yeah, it was right here. Great. Doo-doo. Right, he's the one who has like a German accent.
Let go.
Easy now. You're in a bad way.
It's the squid. Where is my Frenchman?
The squid's gone. Your mate was torn apart.
That. The beast is dead. How did you kill it?
We didn't. It left with the storm. Captain came up from the hold. Said he chased it off. You should rest.
A curse like that? Does that live for nothing?
I actually hear his heartbeat. So I'm guessing he was also torn apart by the beast. And we know this was the other one from Austria, Alfred Clistel. And he is missing an arm. So I'm thinking he was torn apart by the beast. Yes! Yes, that was three correct fates! Alfred Clistel, the bosun. Boatswain. Bosun. And Nuncio Pasqua was knifed. And John Naples, the seaman. Sweet! Now we just need. What was that, 9? Now we just need. 55. Oh god. Okay. Awesome. Now he said something very interesting. Yeah. Perished. And I think we last live stream, we also scoffed on that. The squid, where's my Frenchman? The squid's gone. Your mate was torn apart. Your mate was torn apart. So if we take a look at the crew, we know Alfred Clistel was the bosun, and then there was Charles Minor, the other one, who was the bosun's mate, and he was from France. He was torn apart. We have seen only one being torn apart by the beast. And I believe that was our tattooed man. Where do we have the tattooed man? Tattooed man? I totally forgot where he was. Oh, there he was, torn apart by the terrible beast. And let's see, he was the bosun's mate. Maybe that's correct. That was one. I need two. That was one. Okay, hopefully he's correct. Great. Now we just need to determine two more. I really, really want to determine this guy. But I don't know yet who he is. Okay, never mind then. So who did we miss? Oh, we are inside of memory now. And then it was the two dead guys. Let's just go on with the memory. Two dead guys up here. Why did they die? Did they kill each other? Probably.
What the hell is going on? What do you know about these things? About the chest and your dead friends?
Very dangerous.
Shell? What shell?
Oh my. Okay, so they had a translator. I guess this is the translator. He talk about shell. He died by the beast that they picked up from the sea. And together with the shell, he was warning about the shell, so it's pretty sure that he was spiked by a monster. It's pretty sure that the Formosan were guarding the, or had the shell with them, right? Guarding it, yes. No, they weren't guarding it, they were... The music really doesn't fit what we are here to do. Yeah, some of the music is really, really good and fitting, I think. And then there's something that's still good, really good, but it's like a little bit too upbeat. Translator, maybe part of the framing party. Maybe. Oh, did they both get killed by the spike? Oh, no, not strangled. Spiked by a terrible beast. Oh, that was not what I wanted. Oh yeah, it went through both of them. Holy smokes. Okay. I want to know who that guy is. What the hell is going on? Lift this out and take it below. What do you know about these things? About the chest and your dead friends? What are these monsters? Where are they from? You must tell us everything. Oh, this wasn't actually... Oh, this was a translator. Okay, yeah, he translated. This is your fault. The shells must be protected. We will all die. Okay. No one said any names. Yeah, that sucks. But they were both spiked by a terrible beast. Spiked by a terrible beast. We know he's one of the Formosans. Wait, what? You don't have to. Please explain. Try anyway. All right. So who else was dead here? Oh my god. No one said any names, that's true. Unholy Captives. Those were all the people dead at Unholy Captives. Mm-hmm. Five people. Okay. And the trolley spirit turns around. And you should land right here where I am, shouldn't you? Thank you. Is this his dead friends? Probably. It makes sense, I guess.
Ahoy!
Well back!
Here's the captain!
Ahoy!
Recover's aboard!
Wait! Don't shoot!
Avast.
I have treasure! I yield!
Hold your fire! Ah.
Oh. I have treasure, I yield. Oh! Now we're in a boat. Wait, he killed... Oh. Are we walking on the ocean? That's cool. So So he has a hat. So he's a maid, probably. Oh, now I can see what this is. Is it a mermaid? Oh, some sort of fish with arms. That's the king. Is he dead? Well, he's at least he's missing an arm. Oh no! Is that the seashell we're walking? Yeah, this is cool. So the whole royal family died here. The chronology of the events are. Oh, they got kidnapped to find the shells, I guess. They're calling. Oh, it was Nichols. Oh, he was. This was the guy who framed the. Oh, the chronology of events is very confusing right now. This was the guy who framed one of the Formosan. Guards. For the murder of that guy Pasco. And then afterwards, they kidnapped the. The other Formosans, and they died somewhere. And then, this last guard is killed. All right, we're walking in the moonlit sky. No one caught what I was going on about. Ah, walking in the air, we are floating in the moonlight sky. The people far below are sleeping as we fly. Is that a song? I don't know. Sorry, I didn't catch it. I don't actually know the song or a poem. Sounds pretty good, though. He was shot by a gun by the guy we don't know its name of, whose name we don't know. There was a seashell here. Okay, the royalty. How did he die? Are we going off the ship now? Oh, I think we. Well, he's lying right here. I think. So, Spirit, could you please just. It's walking in the air and there's a whole cartoon short for it. Oh. Okay. Well, I didn't know that. Who's made the song? There's something wrong with his arm. This king's arm.
Shoot your.
Mr. Lin. Are you there? Oh, we got burned. Oh, sugar, man. And he is dragging these mermaid types. The original was by Howard Blake. Okay, I don't actually know who that is. Sorry. So the seashell started burning. We're gonna get Miss Lim's fate in a second. The seashell started burning, didn't it? Something started burning in there. That's the seashell. Yeah, there is the seashell. Or another seashell, it could be multiple seashells. We don't actually know his name yet! Oh! We know who he is. He's royalty. How did he die? He got burned to death. please let's get her fate decided. It's played on... the cartoon is The Snowman. It's played on TV every Christmas in Finland. I've probably seen it then. But I'm not sure. The Snowman? Maybe. Oh, do I have to follow it? Come on, you're gonna end right here. Oh, all right. Last memory for this before the break. Let's go get Miss Lim's death fate. I have it. Hold on. Whoa. But how did she die? They have seashells in their hair. Oh god, dude. What were you doing? What did you bring? Oh, there's multiple. This guy. And that guy. What happened? What happened to her? She might have been stabbed by a spear. Ah, I thought we could get her fate. Maybe not. Okay, thanks. I'll watch that at some point. Maybe after the live stream, I'll take a look at it. Hunlan Lim met an unknown fate. Well, she was speared by an unknown attacker. Okay. Maybe it'll be clearer if we can see what happened just before. Maybe. And I think we are gonna do that. It's the very first thing after the break. So let's take 5 minutes, guys. Whoop. And yeah. Be sure to get back here in 5 minutes.